Okay, welcome to my channel Maths with Manthi sir. Children, in this class let us discuss how to find the mean of a continuous frequency distribution as well as discrete frequency distribution using the last method, that is your step deviation method. Earlier we have discussed what is shortcut method or assumed mean method and the long method or the direct method of calculating mean of continuous frequency distribution as well as your discrete frequency distribution. Let us see what is step deviation method. Okay, so in order to understand the principle of step deviation method in calculating the mean of a continuous frequency distribution or discrete frequency distribution, what procedure is followed? Okay, what are the principles? Okay, so the steps and the principles, let me explain with the help of one example. Okay, let us consider a continuous frequency distribution. See, suppose you are given a continuous frequency distribution. These are class intervals, these are their corresponding frequencies. All the classes are continuous, you know, all these, okay. Now, how to find the mean of this continuous frequency distribution by step deviation method? Okay, what is step deviation method? Now, before I discuss the steps, first let me tell you what is the formula. You see, look at the formula. The formula of step deviation method is what? The mean is given by the formula x bar equal to a plus sigma fi into ui divided by n into h. Okay. Now what is a? A is the assumed mean. Already I gave you the concept of assumed mean in the shortcut method of calculating mean of a continuous frequency distribution and a discrete frequency distribution. So a stands for your assumed mean. Sigma fi into ui, it is the product of frequency and ui. What is ui? We are going to discuss it in this particular case or example. And n is your total number of observation or sum of frequencies. And h, what is h? H is your class size, you can say. It is width or class size, okay? So what is this formula? Let us apply this formula to find. This formula is known as step deviation formula, okay? Calculation of mean, calculating mean by step deviation method. This is the formula to calculate the mean of a continuous frequency distribution as well as a discrete frequency distribution by the step deviation method. Okay. Now let us see. Now see, you are given this much only. That means you are given only a continuous frequency distribution. How will you calculate the mean using that formula of the step deviation method? For that, first what you have to find? You have to find the class mark. Like we are finding in the shortcut method or the assumed mean method. So find out ci, class mark, xi. You know how to calculate the class mark. It is the average of the class limits. Okay? That means lower limit plus upper limit by 2. So here lower limit 0, here it is 10. 0 plus 10 by 2. 0 plus 10 by 2, it will be 5. And this will be 10 plus 20 by 2, 15. So like this you calculate. It will be 25. It will be 30. 5, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 5, 15, 25, 30, 35, 45, yes. So these are the xi. Xi means it is the what? It is a class mark or midpoint of each class. Okay. After getting xi or observations, okay, which is equal to the class mark of each class or midpoint of each class, then you have to choose some mean, assumed mean. You see, what I had said earlier in the shortcut method or the assumed mean method, that you can choose any one. You can choose any one of these values from the xi column as the assumed mean. Suppose we will choose 25, look at. Suppose we will choose 25 as the assumed mean from this column. So, you write down here, let the assumed mean A equal to 25. Okay, the assumed mean is chosen from the column containing xi, which is equal to the midpoint of the classes or class intervals. You can choose any one as the assumed mean, no problem. I took 25, you can take 35, you can take 15, no problem. Okay, suppose the assumed mean in this case is 25. Then what is the next step? The next step is you see, find the deviation, you see. Find the deviation that you were doing in shortcut method. Find the deviation of each xi. Find the deviation of each xi from the assumed mean. What is the formula you already know? Di equal to xi minus a. This is the formula. This is the formula to find di. So what is xi? 5. What is the other moment? 25. 5 minus 25 will see. 5 minus 25 it will be minus 20. Okay. Similarly, 15 minus 25 it will be minus 10. 25 minus 25 it will be 0. Then 35 minus 25 it will be 10. 45 minus 25 it will be 20. You see. That means after finding xi and choosing any one of the values from the xi column as the assumed mean, subtract the assumed mean from each xi to get the deviation, okay? And after finding the deviation, what is the next step? You see, the next step is you see, look at the, up to this we were also doing in the method, what, which method? In the method, shortcut method. In the shortcut method of calculating mean, we were doing up to this. What is the next step? I mean, what is the additional step in this step deviation method? What is the other step? You see, up to this we know because we were doing up to this. These are the steps which we were following to calculate the mean of what? Continuous frequency distribution as well as discrete frequency distribution in the shortcut method. Okay. Now, what one more step will be added in step deviation. So, what is that? You see, after finding all DIs, DI means deviations of each score from the assumed mean. After getting the deviations of each score from the assumed mean, what is the next step? Look at the common factor. See, here it is minus 20, minus 10, 10 and 20. See, look at the common factor. What will be the common factor of all these DIs? Find out the common factor. That common factor, you see, common of all DIs, common of all the deviations, it is equal to H, which is also equal to the class size. You see, just you mark one thing here. Look at the common factor. If I ask you what is the common factor of minus 20, minus 10, 10 and 20, the answer is clearly 10. 10 is the common factor of all these DIs, okay, other than 0, of all other DIs, if I ask you what is the common factor, the answer will be 10. Okay, and look at the class size, look at the width of all the classes, it is also equal to 10. That means, common factor of all DIs, it is denoted by H. Look at, H is a variable there in the formula for calculating mean by step deviation method. So this H, what is H? H is nothing but the common of all DIs, I mean common factor, or you can say highest common factor, whatever you say. You can say highest common factor or common factor of all DIs. And it is equal to what? It is equal to the class size or width. Okay. So whatever is the width or size of the class, I mean all the classes, continuous classes, that will be equal to H. And that is also equal to common factor, I mean HCF of all DIs. Okay. Now, in this case, the value of H will be 10. In this case, the value of H, H means the common factor or HCF of all DIs, which is equal to the class size or width of all continuous classes. In this case, it will be 10. Okay. Now, what you will do after finding the value of H, the next step is you find UI. Now, the point is how to get UI. Now, to get UI, what you will do? Divide all deviations by this H or the common factor. Divide each deviation by the common factor or the H, value of H. H which is equal to the class size or which is again equal to, which is also equal to the common factor or highest common factor of all DIs. You divide the value of DI by H. You see. So UI will be equal to, you can say DI by H, or you can say XI minus A by H. Whatever you say, it is okay. So the formula for UI will be equal to DI by H or XI minus A by H. That means it is the ratio of all deviations divided by your common factor, highest common factor of all DIs. Okay, now, so what is the value of H? 10, so minus 20, look at, minus 20 by 10, it will be minus 2. Minus 10 by 10, it will be minus 1. So 0 by 10, it will be 0. 10 by 10 it will be 1, 20 by 10 it will be 2. See, that means in this method there is an additional step. In shortcut method or the assumption method of calculating mean, we were doing up to this step. There was no column UI in the shortcut method. In shortcut method, the last column was DI. Then we were finding the product of FI and DI. But here, in the step deviation method, after finding DI, you have to find UI. And after getting the value of UI, look at FI into UI, there is another column. So you have to make another column. Okay, you have to create another column which should contain the product of FI and UI. Okay, so now the next column is, you see, now the next column will be your FI into UI. Okay, let us find the product of frequency, I mean FI and UI. The values of UI you got minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. Now these values, they must be multiplied by their corresponding frequencies, you see. So what is the frequency? The first one is, look at the first class interval. What is the frequency? 7. And what is the value of UI? It is minus 2. 7 into minus 2, it is minus 14. Okay. Now it is, what is the next frequency? 10. 10 into minus 1, it is minus 10. Okay. Then 15 into 0, it will be 0. Then 8 into 1, it will be 8. Then your 10 into 2, it will be 20. See. Now I got all the values of the product of FI and UI. Then what I have to do? We have to add all these. We have to add all these in order to find sigma FI UI. You see, in order to find the value of sigma FI UI, we have to add all these. Okay, let us add. You see, 20 plus 8, it is how much? 10 into minus 1 is minus 10. 10 into minus 1, it is minus 10. Yes. Minus 10. Look at. So 20 plus 8, 28. These are positive values. Then minus 10, minus 14. It will be minus 24. See, 28 minus 24, it will be 4. Okay. Now, so the summation of the product of FI and UI is equal to 4. Now you put this, substitute all the values in the formula. Substitute all these values of sigma FI UI, the value of H and the value of A in the formula for step deviation method so that you will get the mean. Therefore, now you can apply the formula. Therefore, the mean of this continuous frequency distribution, what is the formula? A plus sigma FI UI divided by N into H. This is the formula for step deviation method. Now put the values. What is the value of A we have taken? Assume mean 25. Now substitute here 25. Sigma FI UI, what is the value? 4. What is the value of N? N means you have to add all these. You see 10, 8. 10 plus 8, 18. 28, 33. 43, 50. It is 50. You see. N is 50. Sigma FI is 50. Then H, what is the value of H? H is 10, you see. H is 10. So now you do the calculation. 0, 0 you cancel. It is 4 by 5. Now you calculate in your own way. You will calculate now. Now you will calculate and find the value. Therefore, X bar will be equal to 25 plus 4 by 5. Okay. 4 by 5 means it is 0.8. 4 by 5 means it is 0.8. So the sum is 25.8. You see. So the mean of this continuous frequency distribution will be 25.8. And we calculated the mean of this continuous frequency distribution by which method? By applying the step deviation method. Children, I hope you understood what is step deviation method, what is the formula, what is the principle of this method and what are the steps to be followed. What are the steps to be followed to calculate the mean of continuous frequency distribution using the step deviation method? I hope you must have understood. Okay. And we can also apply this particular method to find the mean of what? Discrete frequency distribution also. That means when the observations are not class intervals. When the score of the observations are not class intervals, we can also apply step deviation method. It is of course very time saving. It is a time saving method to calculate the mean of continuous classes, I mean continuous frequency distribution as well as discrete frequency distribution. Children, I discussed all the three methods. The direct or the long method of calculating mean. Then in another class I discussed your shortcut method or the assumed mean method. to calculate mean of continuous classes and discrete frequency distribution. And in this class, we discussed how to calculate the mean of continuous frequency distribution using the step deviation method. We can apply this principle in a similar manner to find the mean of what? Mean of your discrete frequency distribution. Children, I hope you must have understood all the three methods of calculating mean. Okay. So with this, the first measure of central tendency, that is mean, how to calculate by different methods. Okay. How to calculate mean of group data and your continuous class in continuous frequency distribution or continuous classes by following different methods, you must have understood. Okay. So with this, the mean part is over. In the next class, we are going to discuss what is median and how to calculate median and mode. There are two other measures of central tendency also, namely median and mode, which we have not read in class 9. We have read only how to find median and mode of one group data, but we do not know how to find median and mode of what? Your continuous classes or continuous frequency distribution. We are going to discuss all these things in the class 10. So we will discuss the concept of median and mode of continuous frequency distribution in the next class. Okay, children, I hope in this class, whatever I explained, you must have understood. If at all it is true, please hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Okay, thank you.